Hi there. In this video, I'm going to transform this speaker that I built a few years ago. Link will be in the description of this video if you want to see how I built it. To transform it into a self-powered, self-amplified karaoke, radio, Bluetooth, whatever you want, speaker with this module. Let me show you a bit of, about it from Aima. And this is a fairly powerful unit, so should be really good for this big Visaton speaker. Okay, as most passive speakers, this thing has a connection on the back of it. I will not even open it up. I can do everything I need directly from this area on the speaker. So I will undo the screws, take it out, cut the wires and push them back in, and then make a bigger hole into which this particular module will fit. So let me show you this module and then start working in here. So let me show you what you get when you buy this module. The module itself, which has two microphone inputs for karaoke. You can adjust their volume, obviously, echo if you want to add some. I was rudely interrupted by a phone call, so sorry about that. We have here the volume itself, master volume, treble and bass. And here the awesome thing, it also has directly to 20 volts in my case input, but as you can see, it works from 100 to 240 volts, which is perfect. It also has a possibility to put a line in input into this thing if you need. It can play music directly from your USB drive, from your SD card. Here it has a connection for the... Actually, it's not a connection. My bad. That is for the remote itself. I was thinking I need to put some kind of wire to extend it, but no. That's basically just a hole for the IR sensor. Or actually, no. This is one. This is the IR sensor. So this, you might actually put an IR extension if you want to. That's interesting. So a cable basically with a LED at the end of it or something like that, an IR LED. Anyway, here you have controls for when you are using these two inputs. And here, power, which is self-explanatory. And you can also use it, this thing, at 12 or 24 volts, which is awesome. So you can use it in your car. You get this wire which plugs into here, so you can use it directly into the car, which is cool. You have these two wires that actually plug into here. The main output is this one, and this is a tweeter output. Oopsie, I caught this thing by mistake in here. So this basically it's the inputs board up until here. This is the 12 volt input power board actually, and this is this about transforms your this your AC input, so 220 volts for me this part, and this whole thing from here to here is for amplification basically. And yes, tone and echo and microphone and whatnot. So, and the main amplification chip might be on this board. And they have become extremely power efficient. So, in some cases, they don't even need a heatsink. We'll see about this. I'm not expecting it to heat up, honestly. Hopefully, it is loud enough for what I need, but I think it will be. And yeah, we also have a remote if we are lazy and don't want to always go to the back of this thing to adjust things. So let's do this. Undo this thing, make a bigger hole for it, connect it, solder some wires, and we should be good to go. So hopefully this is a quick job. But this thing, if it's working as I expected, it's awesome. This is out. I will unsolder the wires, but I will keep in mind which is positive and keep them in a bundle, which is negative and keep them in a bundle. We don't wanna mix wires from this bundle with wires from this, you would have problems. If you fully switch all of them, this being a single speaker, you will actually reverse the phase, but it will not matter. When you have two speakers in a stereo setup, then it matters. But anyway, I don't want to reverse anything, so I will keep in mind that this is positive, the whole bundle, and this whole bundle negative. Corner holes drilled, and with this I will make cuts between them and should be good enough for this thing to fit in there. And then we will drill some small holes, 6 of them, 3 on top, 3 on bottom, to hold it in place. Let's get to it. Cut the main lines, now just 2 more lines to cut with this, and hope everything is okay. And we're done. Now let me just test and hope for the best. Could be bad or could be good. And it's good. Ha! Nailed it with minimum measuring. Okay, cleaned the inside of this thing with a vacuum and then with this. Again, how I'm doing it here is a bit in a hurry because it's 24th of December 2020 and I want to listen to some Christmas music on this thing. So yeah, I know it's not the proper way to do it, but if it works in the end and doesn't look bad, well, I guess it's good. So next, I'm actually going to do something else. I will leave the wires exactly as they are. And I think I'm directly going to solder them to this board and I'm going to use only this output, the main one. I think this is a full range output and this is only tweeter. I don't think this is something like subwoofer plus tweeter. I think this is a full range. From what I understood in the specifications, you are not necessarily connecting something to this, only if you want to. So I'm just going to connect everything to this. I could potentially use this plug they supplied, obviously, and plug it in there and solder to its wires. But I can also solder to the back of this thing. I feel lazy, so let's solder to the back of it. Okay. So, in the tradition of the day, a quick solder job. Positive to positive, negative to negative. Rotate this thing, push it in there, put some screws, cover the holes, and we are done. Okay, everything is done. This thing is tightened in place. This is the antenna for the radio, I think. So it will remain, yeah, normally I should unwrap it and leave it hanging longer, but whatever, I'm not using the radio at the moment. Let's plug this in and give it a bell. And I think this is the signal that it's waiting to connect to Bluetooth. And yeah, I will play a bit with it and then come back to you with some results, some tests, and the conclusion. Up until now, seems to be working. Okay, so this is a few days later. I've been listening to music, especially Christmas music, through this thing. It's good. It's easy to connect with the phone to it, like any Bluetooth external speaker, obviously, and it's loud. So if you want to have a party with this thing, This can do it for sure. So there's that. I have a single complaint about it. It has background hiss. Let me try and show you that background hiss. Hope my phone will pick it up. Yep, so the hiss is there. I tried a few variants, for example, powering it through 12 volts with that thing, and obviously this port in here. The hiss is absolutely identical. Also, the hiss does not change with the volume at all. Tone also does not affect the hiss at all. And what that means, from what I did a bit of online digging, the hiss is because a really high gain is used for the amplifier stage. So it's a really powerful amplifier, but using a really high gain, any noise from the circuitry is amplified a lot. You could potentially modify a bit the circuit to lower the noise level, but you will also lower the maximum volume that this thing can output. And I think this was optimized for maximum volume. So, yeah, there's that. I will live with it. Maybe someday, if I'm really bored, I will try to do something about it and modify the circuit, but I don't think so. Yeah, this is the only downside, but for what this speaker is meant to do, meaning play really loud, where are lots of people, this thing will be doing it without issues. Tested the other inputs, all work really well, so that's perfect. Apart from karaoke, I did not test that one. Radio works, which is quite nice. So, yeah, there's that. Let me give you a hint, and a little test of how this thing is able to play music. And see how it sounds if you like it or not. Okay, so I'm simulating the first connection to this thing. Let me see about the volume. Yeah, it's about at this level. So I will power it off. As you can hear, it's popping when you power it off.
Bluetooth device is ready to pair.
Okay, it's waiting to be paired. And it will wait to be paired only the first time. The second time, when you try it, it will pair by itself. So,
the Bluetooth device is connected successfully.
as you can see, it connected automatically the second I turned my Bluetooth on because it was already paired to it. I already listened to music. So, yeah, it's this easy. Now, let me give it some music and show you how this thing sounds. Okay, let's make sure the volume is quite low at the moment. Okay, take this with us, and I will also go and search for the remote to show you how the remote control works. Okay, this is the remote control, and yes, it will only work from the back of this thing. So if you are on the sides, for example, let's try the volume. It's not going to work from the front. Again, it's not going to work, but from the back of this thing. As you can see, lower or increase the volume. But it's quite sensitive to the direction you point the remote at, so maybe the battery is a bit weak. You have here controls, and they do actually even work with Bluetooth. As you can see, we can change the melody. Next, previous, everything works. And you can even turn it off. But again, you need to be at the back of this thing to do that. So there's that again. Let me give you a hint on the sound, and then we will do an excursion test. Because honestly, I wasn't expecting that thing to be able to drive this 15-inch Visaton speaker at a really high level. I was expecting it to drive it, but not at high volume, because it's not advertised for 15-inch speakers. Normally in the specifications of that module, it's said to work for 12-inch speakers maximum, but it seems it's powerful enough for this thing. And yeah, I will also link a video in the description where I show how I repaired this speaker that I bought, I think for under $10 or something like that. So yeah, homemade thing, paid $20 for the whole of it or something like that. So yeah, good enough. Let's play some music a bit louder. Okay, if it would not have this hiss that you can clearly hear, hopefully it shows up on camera, this would be awesome. With the hiss, if you listen to music at low volume, this will not work for you, but if you listen to music at high volume, you will not care about the hiss. Again, without this hiss, the module itself is really clear in the sound it produces. Maybe I even got a defective unit that has this hiss, or all of them are like this, I do not know. Anyway, yeah, there's that. Now, next, let me give you an excursion test and see how that works out. Okay, as you could see, this thing is driving the speaker really well, so happy with it overall. And yeah, that's that for this video. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments. And yeah, this is a really simple way of transforming any speaker, homemade or boat or wherever you found it into a powered Bluetooth and USB and whatever, all of them radio speaker. So that's quite cool and quite simple. You saw how easy it was. Drill a hole in the back of this thing, put this module in here, connect to wires, and you are done. So there's that. Again, hope this video helps you in some way. And as always, see you in the next one. And thank you, Aima, for sending this this unit to me. Bye. Just wanted to share something else with you. Put this thing into its normal listening location and maxed it out for more than half an hour just to see if anything heats up on that metal on the back of the module. Absolutely nothing. And this thing, it's barely distorting at maximum volume. So it's almost perfect sounding even at its absolute max. And I think it's almost maxing out this 15-inch speaker. So, yeah, impressed with this module. Hope it wouldn't had that bit of hiss. But if you have, I don't know, a PC in the same room with this thing, it will be probably the fans in the PC at almost the same level as this thing. So, maybe in the background. So, yeah, there's that. This thing, this module is awesome. Okay, and again, bye.